Good morning, dear students. Last day we were discussing about chapter 5, the shopping list mystery. We already completed the first page and till the middle of page number 46. Today we are going to start from the middle paragraph. He turned to Sandeep and said, from there onwards. I hope you already find out difficult word meanings. That was the homework of yesterday. We were seeing the different reactions towards Sandeep's hobby of playing violin. His mother and father was against his hobby, but his uncle Shekhar was supporting him. Uncle turned to Sandeep and said, I am interviewing the famous Italian violinist Antonio Sacchirini today. Why don't you meet me at the chronologist conference? Later, we can both meet Signor Sacchirini. Sandeep was very happy and he immediately agreed to that. He seriously avoided his mother's disapproving eyes, but he was very happy and excited to go and meet this famous violinist. The next evening, Sandeep arrived early at the World Criminologist Conference. The highlight of the day was Great Unsolved Crimes. As Sandeep slipped into his seat, the gentleman on the stage was saying, one half of the cryptography department of the Belgian police, I came to the case of the unsolved shopping list mystery. Sandeep leaned forward in interest. He knew that cryptography was the science of reading messages written in complicated codes. Some criminals used to write some words or some quotations in the dead bodies in order to frighten the people or in order to confuse the police officers for their investigation. Some criminals used to write something on the dead bodies or nearby walls, some hidden messages. That is called codes. And cryptography was the science of reading messages written in complicated codes. The person who was standing in the stage continued his talk. Belgium is famous for its fine diamond jewelry. Recently, Les Cabochons, one of the largest jewelry stores in Brussels, came to us with a very odd complaint. Over the past years, several of their customers had been robbed while on their way with a lot of money to pick up jewelry they had ordered. The store was worried that an insider was involved and was in league with the criminal elements. The members of that store worried that or suspected that one among them is doing this criminal activity. They got some criminal elements too, because when one person orders jewelries, an insider only can understand about their address, phone number and about the person. Normally, in order to buy a lot of jewelry, people used to visit the jewelries prior and select their ornaments, fix the date and money. Later, they will come with the money and take those selected ornaments. In order to do that, we want to provide our address details, our phone number, and also we want to meet other security requirements of that jewelry. Because of this, the jewelry member worried or suspected that an insider was involved in those robberies. The man in the stage continued, we checked every employee and narrowed our suspicion down to a lady called Jane Egmont, whose job was to take down orders. She rang up customers to inform them that their order was ready and would ask whether they would pay in cash or by check. She would offer to keep the bill ready if they were let her know when they were coming. A study of the people who were robbed revealed that the same lady had served them all. This was the reason behind narrowing their old suspicion towards that lady. She called to every customer and informed that their order is ready. And also, she will ask whether they are going to pay in cash or by check. She also will inquire about the time when they are coming in order to make their bills ready. So all this information is enough and more to Rob when they are arriving at the shop. The person in the stage continued that we began to follow her. We noticed that she was doing something very odd when she went to one small grocery store. She handed over her shopping list to the owner after she had picked up whatever she wanted. Normally, no one hands over the shopping list after they complete their shopping. We realized the list was the code by which she was passing on the message. Normally, we will hand over the shopping list to the shopkeeper or his helper in order to take all the things for us. But here, what she was doing is, she will take all the things whatever necessary and after that, she will give the shopping list. That is a very odd behavior. So they realized the list was the code which she is passing to the shopkeeper and those people can arrange robbery according to the time and the written address which that lady gave to them. The person in the stage continued his talk. Within a few days, when another customer was robbed, we arrested Jane Egmont and the grocery shop owner. But the mystery was unsolved. Though the robberies stopped with this arrest, we could never prove Jane Egmont guilty. Which means that within a few days of this shopkeeper's finding that Jane Egmont is behind these robberies and she is collecting the information like whether the customer is paying by cash, when they are coming and about their address and all, one more robbery happened. That day, they arrested Jane Egmont and that grocery shop owner, but they were unable to collect all the information. There was no much proof which shows Jane Egmont and the grocery shop owner was involved in these robberies. What happened after the arrest of Jane and that grocery shop owner? That we will see in the next class.